In anticipation of the soon to be released quantum body, the new science of living a longer, healthier, and more vital life, my book with Jack Tuzinski, a quantum biologist and quantum physicist, and Brian Fertig, I am proposing other ideas that expand on the book in these videos, and hopefully we'll create an online book club. Let me know if that's a good idea so we can all discuss the chapters in the book, but also share our opinions and our interpretations and so forth. So let me know. Today I want to address the fundamental principles of quantum mechanics, and hair is a mess. Today I want to address the fundamental principles of quantum mechanics and see how we can relate them to the human mind, but also to what might be addressed as quantum consciousness. Just another word, but I think words and distinctions between definitions sometimes clarify things. So right now, mainstream science does not think about quantum mind. In fact, it's very dismissive. It also calls it, what do you call it, quantum mysticism. When I talk about it, it addresses it as pseudo scientific profound bullshit or something like that. But let me try and see if we can make a case for quantum consciousness, quantum mind, and of course quantum body, etc. And let's start with the fundamental proposition that there is a fundamental field that we can call the source of all reality. Mainstream science calls that fundamental field the quantum field and considers it to be an objective reality, even though we have to come up with the idea of the quantum field based on experiments and theories and observation, all in our own consciousness. As I've said many times before, that theories are conceived in consciousness, experiments are also designed in imagination and consciousness, and observations are made in consciousness. So what physicists call the objective quantum field in Eastern wisdom traditions is referred to as a field that is imbued with subjectivity. Once again, what mainstream science calls the objective quantum field is referred to in Eastern wisdom traditions as fundamental reality, and the same field that scientists are talking about as the quantum field is imbued with subjectivity. It is here that both the principles of quantum mechanics and the principles of quantum mind are, it is only here that they have their source. The principles of quantum mechanics, also the idea of quantum mind. But now looks at some parallels and similarities between the two concepts, quantum mechanics and let's call it quantum mind, both having their source in quantum consciousness or fundamental consciousness or fundamental reality, or just let's say the consciousness field. Doesn't matter, whatever appeals to you. So the first principle of quantum mechanics is what we call quant wave particle duality. Basically, wave particle duality is a principle that says every object in the universe has both particle-like and wave-like properties. That means that objects can behave like waves spreading out over space and time, and they can also behave like particles localized in space and time. What's the analogy of the mind? Your mind has a wave-like property in that before you actually have a thought, it is a cloud of possibilities as a wave. And then when you have a thought, it becomes particle-like. So that's the first similarity. The second parallel or similarity in quantum mechanics and quantum mind is that in quantum mechanics, there's a principle called quantization, energy momentum, angular momentum, and other quantities of a bound system are restricted to discrete values. This means that these quantities cannot take on any arbitrary value, but must be one of a specific set of values. So if you just change the word energy to experience, and then change the word experience to qualia, because that's how we experience, then you can see that qualia also have the same analogous properties. Qualias are qualities of consciousness or unities of consciousness. Let's say the color red, or the taste of wine, or the smell of garlic. Discrete, okay, very discrete qualia experience, and that qualia experience cannot take in any other arbitrary value, in a sense, very similar, right? The third principle in quantum mechanics is something called the uncertainty principle. It's impossible to simultaneously know the exact position and momentum of a particle with perfect accuracy. The more accurately one knows one quantity, the less accurately one can know the other. Now think of your thoughts. It's impossible to localize a thought, and it's impossible actually to even measure the movement of thought. Our thoughts occur with lightning speeds in the same way as particles pop in and out of existence at lightning speed. So our thoughts and our mental activities, thoughts entangled with sensations, images, and feelings, are very similar. They embody the uncertainty principle. You cannot even predict your next thought. So they embody the uncertainty principle. You cannot actually simultaneously localize a thought and also experience it as a stream of consciousness. So that's a similarity as well, an analogy. Another principle is superposition. A quantum system can be in superposition of multiple states at the same time. This means the system can be in a state that is a combination of two or more states. Well, in the same way, our clouds of probabilities before we actualize a thought are in multiple states simultaneously, and they're entangled with each other as well. Okay, so that's another similarity. And then there's the collapse of the wave function, which says that when a quantum system is measured, it collapses into a single state. The probability of the system collapsing into a particular state is given by the square of the wave function for that state. That's, of course, Schrodinger's equation. Now, just think of the same thing. The collapse of a wave function, which is mind, results in a particular state of that mind, which is a thought. Okay, so a thought is the collapse of the probabilities and the state of awareness that we call mind, fluctuations of mind. So now we can see that the foundational principles of quantum mechanics that have revolutionized our understanding of the universe are very simple, but they have mind-like qualities. Okay, and finally, there's one more principle in quantum mechanics, which I've hinted at right now. It's called quantum entanglement. two or more quantum systems can be entangled in such a way that they share the same fate, even if they are separated by large distances. This means that measuring one system will instantly collapse the wave function of the other system, even if the two systems are not causally connected. Quantum entanglement is considered by physicists a strange and fascinating phenomenon, but has been experimentally verified and has the potential to revolutionize the field of quantum computing. I would say that your consciousness is a qualia computing system where actually many states of mind, from fear to anxiety to guilt to shame to depression to love to compassion to joy to equanimity, are all entangled, and they're non-locally connected, and actually they're aspects of the wave function of consciousness that we call mind. These are the similarities, and we understand quantum body, then we see that if we understand quantum mind, then we see quantum body is an extension of that, and quantum universe is entangled with quantum body. You need this body to experience the human universe. This and the human universe are entangled as well. So quantum consciousness, all possibilities and clouds of probability. Quantum mind, clouds of probability coalescing into feelings, emotions, thoughts, etc. And then quantum body, the entanglement of all the cells, non-locally correlated with each other. And then quantum universe, the projection of that. If this makes any sense, then let's continue our explorations in the new book club that we are launching. We'll start with this book, but we'll actually go into all other books, including You Are the Universe, and that book you see on my bookshelf, Life After Death and Quantum Healing and Meta Human and Total Meditation, etc., etc. Let me know your thoughts.